It's the ultimate he said, she said scenario.
You loved her?
Yes.
So far as you could ascertain, she loved you as well?
Yes.
In my mind, it wasn't significant enough because I didn't know where it was going and I didn't feel comfortable with his level of commitment.
So, how did we get here? Last year, the state corruption watchdog was investigating former member for Wagga, Darryl Maguire. When they tapped his phone, they uncovered a bombshell, a secret relationship with then-premier Gladys Berejiklian.
It's worse than the Spanish Inquisition. They could be taping your conversation with me right now. You wouldn't know.
ICAC since recommended Maguire face criminal charges, and now they're investigating Gladys herself to find out what she knew and whether she played favourites. Explosive recordings suggest Maguire tried to leverage his relationship with Berejiklian, demanding money for projects of dubious worth in his electorate.
I've already got you the Wagga Hospital. I just spoke to Dom and I said, just put the 140 in the budget. He goes, no worries. He just does what I ask him to. You can't have me fixing all the problems all the time.
Maguire even seemed to brag about his alleged corrupt activities.
Yeah, I'm getting a big tax return, I'm told. Just repeat after me, 1.5 million.
I'm not going to say any such thing.
No, just repeat it. So I'm going to solve that problem now.
But today, the former Premier was adamant. His shakedown attempts weren't successful.
I was always able to distinguish between my private life and my public responsibilities.
And despite the damning audio, she never suspected Maguire of serious misconduct.
Did you suspect that Mr. Maguire was or may have been engaged in corrupt conduct?
I did not. He was always talking big and I didn't pay too much attention to that.
She also insisted their relationship wasn't serious enough to raise a perceived conflict of interest.
No, I did not regard him as a member of my family.
Even as evidence to the contrary continues to mount.
You're saying to Mr. Maguire, but you're my family, did you say that there?
Well, that's a turn of phrase, but I did not mean it in the context that I regarded him as family.
You contemplated marriage?
Yes.
With her?
Yes.
There was discussion about potentially having a child?
Yes.
With her private life under the microscope, Berejiklian bristled at the lines of questioning.
That is absolutely not the case. I reject it outright and I find it offensive.
The affairs already cost her the top job, but could it get even worse for the former Premier?
James O'Doherty from the Daily Telegraph has been following this story closely. James, wow. Talk us through what you feel was the standout moment from what was a massive day today.
Well, look, there was a lot. There were a number of standout moments right from the beginning of the evidence where she said that she would have done everything exactly the same. She wouldn't have declared her relationship if she was given the opportunity. And right at the end, where Gladys Berejiklian was played phone taps from Darryl Maguire's phone when Mr. Maguire phoned her to tell her that he had been subpoenaed for a previous ICAC investigation, the investigation which got us into this whole thing. They were even discussing the possibility that their phones could be tapped. It turns out they were, but it was a massive day of evidence at the ICAC and it'll happen all again on Monday.
Given how volatile it got at times, do you feel there are any cracks in the former Premier's defence that are starting to emerge?
Well, look, far be it for me to surmise and suppose what the Commission will eventually find. And, of course, Gladys Berejiklian denies all wrongdoing. But there does seem to be a particular part of her evidence that is at least raising some questions with Counsel Assisting and the Commissioner, Assistant Commissioner Ruth McColl. Gladys Berejiklian kept suggesting today that Darryl Maguire and her relationship was not of sufficient substance for her to declare it under the New South Wales Ministerial Code of Conduct, despite making previous disclosures about her cousins working in the public service, for example. At one point, Assistant Commissioner Ruth McColl asked Gladys Berejiklian whether she had a deep emotional commitment to Mr. Maguire. Gladys Berejiklian said she did. But then she said that the threshold question essentially hadn't been passed. There was not the threshold for her to disclose it. Assistant Commissioner Ruth McColl said, well, those threshold questions, they're up to us.
James, not being forthcoming enough with ICAC can eventually lead to criminal prosecution. Do you feel like that could be a real prospect here, given the fact there's this constant deferring away from actually answering a lot of these questions around how close they really were and the influence that he may have had over her?
Look, if there are any recommendations for criminal charges, it'll be a while to come before that happens. And even once that does happen, the DPP will face the question of whether they want to pursue the charges, and ICAC doesn't have the best strike record when it comes to actual criminal charges. The real potential damage from Ms. Berejiklian here is the reputational damage of spending two full days and two bruising days in front of the corruption watchdog.
Well, James, as far as television dramas goes, this is juicier than a reality show. Thank you very much for your time tonight.
Thanks, guys.